Hi, Tom here at Our Pastime. A little video for you today. I'd like to remind you to like, subscribe, leave a comment, give me that thumbs up, and we'll keep more of these cub videos coming your way. Hope you enjoy them. I enjoy making them, even though today I may not enjoy them quite as much in the cold temps. But I just want to let you know I'm doing it all for you. And I hope you appreciate it. This is probably going to be the worst video I've ever made. It's me adjusting the clutch on the Farmall cub. You may have noticed on that last video that I did not finish spreading all the 3/4 gravel out. Well, there was a reason for that, and that was the clutch started to give out, or wear out, or something. I stopped being able to stop the cub. I push in the clutch, and there was no release of the clutch at all. The tractor would keep going. So the only way to stop was to bump it into neutral, and then of course I couldn't get back into gear. So I had to shut down the project early. Now the 3/4 inch gravel pile off to my right over here is kind of frozen. I did put a tarp over it. Most of it froze up anyway, because it's 27 degrees out and wintertime, December 1st. So let's get on with the video showing how to adjust the clutch, and then hopefully I can show you whether or not this actually makes it easier to shift in and out of gear, and if I can shift in and out of gear while the tractor is actually running. All right, enough talking. Let's get busy working. In today's video, the tools used are a half-inch wrench, a offset screwdriver, a ratchet with a grip, a ratchet with a bit driver, ratchet with a spinner, and a hex head bit driver, and a pry bar. Okay, here we are today under a cub, and I need to adjust the clutch. The throwout bearing is at its max, just barely resting on the fingers on the clutch. I think one of the problems is the throwout bearing's just about worn out, but it looks like I have a little bit of adjustment left on the fingers. Right here, what I gotta do is loosen this nut, and then the adjustment screw right there can be turned to allow this arm to push up a little bit more so that it will engage with the throwout bearing, which is back here. So I'm going to attempt to do that so that when I push the clutch in, it will engage with the finger more fully. And apologize for the camera, but it's tight quarters under a cub, and I'll give it my best shot here to show you what's going on. Let's see if we can get, all right, there you can see the nut, and that little nub sticking above the nut is a screw that can be adjusted. It has a little slot in the top. And take one of these, and you can turn it. This one has a double angle, so I should have plenty of room to move. This hole, by the way, is only about 3 inches. That's all the room you have to work with when you want to adjust the fingers on that clutch. So,
going to attempt to loosen each of the three fingers. There's three. And screw that, turn that screw in about maybe 3/4 of a turn or so, maybe a full turn, so that the arm lifts up to engage with the throwout bearing. So let's give that a shot. Loose. Yeah. Oh, sounds like UPS is here. A little more. But that's the idea. You gotta turn that screw and loosen that nut until you get it turned in enough so that the finger pulls up more. Pulls up more. So that's what I'll do. Hold on. I'll get it to the point where I want it and I'll bring you back. All right, that first one's adjusted. And it took about a turn and a half, maybe two turns. But I'm getting good engagement now with that one. Two more to go. And I have a better tool to adjust that center than I showed you before. I'll show you on the next one. Now we have to spin it to the next finger. There's two ways to do this. You can do it right from here by just spin it with the pry bar. It spins pretty easy. An easier way is if you have a helper, you can just spin it with the starting handle, if you still have the starting crank, the manual way to start a cub. Finger number two. Okay, let's loosen that up. A few turns. Old hand in the way. Loosen that counterclockwise. And if I haven't mentioned yet, I'll make sure I mentioned at some point. Oh, that's turning nice and easy now. But it's a 1/2-inch nut, so I'm using a 1/2-inch wrench. And the special tool that adjusts that screw in the middle is this. A crossbin spinner with just a regular hex flat screw bit. Works really well, gets right in there. Once you figure out where the thread is. I'll show you that in just a second, once I get it lined up. Alright, so just set that right there. And let's give it some turns. Easier than using a screwdriver, I found. Especially in tight quarters. Especially when you can't really see what's going on anyway. Well, that's spinning. There's almost one turn, half a turn. There's a full turn. Let's check on the finger. That's coming up against the throat bearing much better. The clutch springs are engaging, compressing much better than before. I don't know if you can see that. So I just need to, I think, turn that a little bit more to match the other one that's up there. I can't really see. Yeah, that other one off to the left is just another half a turn out. I don't know if you can see. I can't see. Just barely see up to the left. Maybe I can put an arrow in the video. It's hard to see. There, maybe you can see that arm up there now. There, now you can see. The other one is touching the throwout bearing, and the one I just adjusted is not yet. So I need to adjust this one a little bit more. All right, let's check for touching. That's better. Much better compressing on the clutch. Let's just check that other arm. Finger. See, the other finger is still feel that Jake break. I'm gonna go another half a turn. Let's check that. Alright, now just touching that the same as the other one. One more to go. Let's tighten that set nut. It's a set nut, I guess. We'll do the third. See, my arm's getting shaky from holding the camera. Whoo! So now all I gotta do is tighten that nut. That will hold the screw. Then we'll have one finger left. One. bigger left. There, tighten that on as tight as I can without using the pinch bar or the pry bar. So now I'll tighten that because that's a two-hand process and I can't do that with the camera, and I just don't have a third hand or a way to hold the camera and show you that. But all I'm going to do is put the pry bar up in here and hold that while I tighten that. With the pry bar. So the pry bar is going to hold the clutch from spinning, and I'm going to give that a final little turn to tighten the nut so it won't spin loose. And that's what I'm doing next. And then we'll spin the clutch one nut to the last finger and work on the last finger. I might be on the compression stroke, spinning a little hard. On the compression stroke, things moved a bit here underneath the tractor. I've got a finger on either side now, touching the throwout bearing, and this last finger is not touching the throwout bearing by a long shot. So we gotta loosen that nut like we did on the other two and turn the screw. Again, all I'm going to do is use the pry bar to loosen that nut. I can't show you that because I just don't have a third arm. So I'll be back after I get that loose. Third one is loosening. Third set nut, I guess you'd call it. According to the other ones, I gotta turn that screw in the center about three times. Three turns in order to get it to where we need it for adjustment. And let's see if we can find the slot. I think I found the slot right off this time. Pretty easy. Wants to adjust. Maybe I say that, now I can't get it in there. There we go. I know this isn't the best video, but it's tight quarters. I'm doing the best I can to show you how to adjust a clutch. And I hope you see, it's not that technical. There's half a turn. It's just a little time consuming. If I can do this with one hand, anybody can do this, because I'm holding a camera while I'm doing most of the work. Oops, I gotta loosen that duct. So, it's not that this is a hard job. It's not really that much to it. It's just doing it. It's tight quarters. Oh, see what I see going on? I'm turning the whole, the screw is not independently turning from the nut. So that's going to require two hands. And I can see the arm. I don't know if you can see that, but each time I turn it, let's see if I can show you. The finger is going further and further in. So I got to, lost all of our forward momentum, outward momentum on that. So I need to unseat the screw from the nut. Hold on just a minute. Okay, many apologies, but this guy in the set, in the set nut and the screw were so tightly, there must have been, I'm not sure what's going on, but anyway, I could not turn one without holding on to the other, so I couldn't film it, but anyway, it's adjusted now. Clutch is, excuse me, the clutch is now, let's see if I can really show that. Of course, now it's completely dark outside, but I think you can see the clutch is now fully touching all fingers. No gaps. And when I pull on the clutch pedal, let's see, we get good compression of the springs inside. Before I was just barely getting any contact whatsoever. But now I'm getting a good You see this little notch right here too? There's a notch right there. And when I pull down, a second notch appears. See? So I think I've adjusted that just about perfect. We'll see tomorrow when it's light and bright outside, and we can see if what I've done has made a difference. Stay tuned.
All right, it's another day, and I'm back out here. I was going to show you the next day whether or not the fix worked, but that day was yesterday, and it was miserable, snowy, rainy, and cold and wet, and wasn't a good day to film. So today, after some Christmas shopping, I get home. I think I have enough daylight to end the video and see whether or not the fix worked with the clutch. So let's unwrap the cub in this breezy day today. And it's not any warmer today. It's 26 degrees. So it'll be a good time to start the cub.
for a cold start because it hasn't been started for a week. This is already the worst video I've ever made as far as quality, so I'm not too worried about shaky camera. Let's get up here and see if we can start this tractor. Brr. 26 degrees. Oh, I got a clutch. The clutch pushes in nice. And it's turning over, protesting a little bit. Let's see. It wants to start. One thing I've noticed already is I'm in gear and the cub is not moving. That was not the case the other day. Cub says it's cold out here. The cub says it's very cold out here. success. I have now have the best working clutch of any Cub that I own. That was a success. Major success through all that cold all those cold temperatures and frozen fingers. That was a really nice result. The clutch works perfectly. There's no, the gears go in and out of their slots without the least bit of grinding, and I am very happy with the result. I do think I'll have to order a new throwout bearing. Well, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. I apologize for the middle part there where it was such a bad, you know, that was a really poor quality. I apologize. But I think you'll see how it's done, and then the results were worth it. And I appreciate you for sticking through the video, watching it. Please subscribe. Yeah, my mouth is frozen out here. Please subscribe. Give me a thumbs up, like the video, show me that you like the video by giving me a thumbs up, subscribe, leave a comment, and hit the bell to be notified for future videos, so you'll be notified when I post new ones. And enough talking, let's end the video, and I'll figure out what the next video is going to be. It's going to be... a while before I get back to this project. Under my 40-foot tarp is all that gravel. I'm trying to keep it from freezing too much over the winter, but I think that's kind of moot at this point. Anyway, thanks for watching. I'll catch you again next time. This is Tom at Our Pastime saying see you later, and thanks for watching. Bye-bye.